Sound design.
I have a friend that seems to find a polarity inversion on almost every show he works on, and I almost never find one, so I'm either not looking hard enough, or I'm just really lucky. So let's talk about how to identify a polarity inversion in Smaart. This can be a quick, easy process. It's one of the very first things we do in the verification step of our sound system tuning roadmap, and it's a thing that you could actually do in the shop the day before, so it doesn't need to really take up any time once you get into the field if you know exactly which speakers you're going to use. But if you're the kind of person that just has to show up and use some unfamiliar equipment, this is probably a step you want to go through so that you don't have to find out later on once you have speakers up in the air that one of them has a polarity inversion and now you need to like take the box apart or take it out of the rig or whatever. So what I'm going to recommend is that you just turn on delay tracking and then basically go from speaker to speaker and just keep an eye on your phase trace here. If you have an assistant, that can make it even easier because then you can just stand and look at the analyzer and you can solo speakers one at a time and your assistant can like move the microphone around. But if you're by yourself, then maybe you have a tablet that you can walk around with, or you might need to move the microphone then come back and look at the display. So let's do it. So I'll push play on my measurement. I'll start up the generator. And I don't hear anything. Okay. Cool, so I'm not even really gonna pay attention to the magnitude trace here. In fact, let's go ahead and do this. That's actually really hard to see though. Let's go back to a regular display. All right, delay tracking on, and I'll stop talking and save the trace. Then all I need to do is move from speaker to speaker and compare. Okay, this one checks out, looks pretty good. I can save it if I want to reference it later. Okay, now I'm about to move on to the sub, but remember, as we talked about in previous videos, the delay locator, automatic delay tracking doesn't work so well with the sub, so I'm gonna turn off the delay locator before I switch to the sub. And I'm actually gonna use the same microphone position because these are matched speakers. They're designed to work together. So my expectation is that with them set up the way they are, with one on top of the other, I should not see a polarity inversion. So let's just try it that way first. I don't know about this. Let me zoom into the low end. Okay, this looks like a polarity inversion to me. Okay, because we've got, what, zero, about around 118, and then we've got negative 180, and positive 180 around that area, okay? So I believe we have identified a polarity inversion. So I could do that at the mixer or the speaker processor. Let me take a look at the sub, though, because sometimes those have a polarity inversion switch. And yes, it turns out that it was set to reversed. Who did that? I don't know, but I'm glad I found it, okay? So I'm glad I checked and didn't have to find out later, and I'm glad it was as easy as that. And now we can see that where it was 180 degrees out before, now we are in alignment again. Another helpful tool to find a polarity inversion is the impulse response. And you can open that up if you don't already have it open by clicking Live IR in Smaart. So let me start up the generator. Hit play on my measurement. All right, so here's my impulse response. And if I zoom in, oops, I need to be able to see the top and bottom. Then I can see that it peaks down first and then up. That means somewhere in my system, there's a polarity inversion. But all I really care about is that they all match. So this would be another good thing to look at as I'm saving my traces and moving from speaker to speaker. Just make sure that they all peak down first. And I realize this window is a little bit small, so it's if you want to head over to the impulse response window, then it starts out looking like this. But if I go to option one, that zooms in, and then I can right click and zoom in even more. There we go. So now it's really obvious that this one is peaking down. So what I would do now is just go from speaker to speaker and hit play. So let's try that. So let's go to the other speaker. There we go. So I've now verified that both of these speakers are peaking down first in the impulse response here and that they have matching polarity. As you can see in the sub window, this is not so helpful. I would have to, I guess, zoom way in like this. And now I can see that it peaks down here, but still a lot harder for me visually to see than just when I was looking over here on the phase response in the transfer window. So that's why I don't actually switch over to the impulse response that much, but it is another good tool to have open. So I guess what I would do most of the time is stay in the transfer window and just have this impulse response open, and you know, Command I can open and close it really quick. So in case I'm wondering like, are these really two? I can just have another piece of information there. And that is how you identify a polarity inversion in Smaart. If you have another way of doing this, I'd love to hear about it. I'm always trying to improve the methods that I use and share with other people. So comment below this video and let me know.
Sound design.